Okay, let's start variance analysis, the last chapter of probability and statistics course, variance analysis, or analysis of variance, or ANOVA. If you see an ANOVA, you have to understand that this is analysis of variance, okay? They are the same. Variance analysis, what's variance analysis? Variance analysis is a statistical method to put the differences among data sets. Okay, we are looking for any, if we have any differences among or between data sets, okay? And we use the variance analysis. Variance analysis is the same with comparison test. Remember from chapter 8, comparison test. In comparison test, we were comparing two sets of data, and we were looking for the different one, or if there is any differences between two sets. The comparison or variance analysis is the same, okay, is the same, but the only difference is by using variance analysis, you can compare more than two data sets at the same time, okay? In comparison tests, you can only test two sets of data. You can only compare two sets of data, but by variance analysis, you can compare two sets of data and together with more than two sets of data. It's very useful, it's very simple one if you have more than two sets of data. And variance analysis, in variance analysis, we are using Fisher distribution. This is the fourth distribution, I think, that we have learned in this course. Fisher distribution? It's a modification of chi-square distribution, okay? It's a modification of chi-square distribution. And this distribution has tables of alpha equals to 0.01 or the 1% table, 5% table, 10% table, and 25% of table. But in our course book, we have only 0.01, I mean 1% and 5% of Fisher table, okay? Yeah, I mean, we will use only 1% or 5% of Fisher table. Okay, how can we make Fisher table? What's the step? What are the steps of variance analysis? Sorry. At the first step, we are setting the hypothesis. Again, we have two hypotheses. H0 says that all the means are the same. There is no differences among the means, okay? H1 says that at least one mean is different than the others, okay? At least one mean is different. At the second step, we are trying to find an F value, which is called as F critical, from Fisher table. How can we get F table from the F value from the table? We will use the F alpha. Alpha will be given, level of error will be given in the problem, in the example. And in parentheses, TDF and RDF. TDF is total degree of freedom. RDF is residual degree of freedom. I will understand, I will tell you that what's the TDF, what's RDF, what is MDF, okay? This one is wrong. Let me correct it. MDF and RDF. Treatment degree of freedom, residual degree of freedom. Okay, let's come to the third steps. In the third step, we are calculating an F value, okay? How we calculate the F value, which is called as F calculated, MMS divided by RMS. MMS is the treatment mean square. RMS is the residual mean square, okay? MMS is treatment mean square, yani muamele kareler ortalaması. RMS is the residual mean square, yani hata kareler ortalaması in Turkish. Okay, at the last step, We are comparing the F critical with F calculated. If F critical is high or higher than F calculated, no problem, we accept H0. But if calculated is greater than F critical, and this time we accept H1. Okay, H1 is accepted. In this steps, everything is very simple, but the calculating F value is a bit a long process. Okay, it's a bit long. How can we find the F calculated? We start from TSS, total sum of squares. Okay, we calculate the total sum of squares by taking the double sum of square of xij, double sum square of xij. I will tell how can we find the double sum of xij square, and minus x double dot square divided by n times p. Okay, I will tell the details when we are solving the example. Okay. At the second step, we are trying to find the F calculated value. At the second step, we are calculating the treatment sum of squares, MSS, I mean. MSS, again, is calculated the sum of xi dot square divided by n minus x double dot square divided by n times p. And at the third step, we are calculating residual sum of squares. We can find the RSS by subtracting TSS from MSS. Okay, TSS is found here, MSS is found here, so we can easily find the amount of RSS. And just a minute, there is an hata var galiba, bir saniye. Evet, doğru. RSS can be found by subtracting the treatment mean square, treatment sum of squares from total sum of squares. Okay, I have changed this one. And how can we find the degree of freedoms? We have three types of degree of freedoms. Total degree of freedom, treatment degree of freedom, residual degree of freedom. How can we calculate the total degree of freedom? We multiply the n with p. What's n and what's p? You see we have n and p. N is the p is the number of data sets that we will compare. Okay, number of data sets that we will compare. N is the number of samples that are taken from each data set. Okay, from each data set, we will take not only one sample, we will take maybe five or six or seven samples. N is the amount of samples that are taken from number of data set that are taken from P, not that are taken from the total data set. Okay. If the data set, if the number of data set is four, and if the samples which are taken from each data set is six, this time we can calculate the TDF as six times four, which is 24, minus one, it's 23. Okay. What about the treatment degree of freedom, MDF? MDF equals to number of data sets minus one. The number of data set was four. Four minus one is three. And the residual degree of freedom is TDF minus MDF. 23 minus three, and it's equal to 20, for example. Okay. At the end, all these calculations is for to get F calculated value, okay? To get F calculated value. At the end, okay, we are coming to the end. Finally, we are calculating the treatment mean square and residual mean square, MMS and RMS. MMS is found by MSS divided by MMDF. RMS can be found by residual sum of squares divided by residual degree of freedom. Okay, now we are ready to find the F calculated value. F calculated value is the treatment mean square MMS divided by RMS. MMS is called as the variance of treatment at the same time, okay? MMS is the variance of treatment. RMS is the variance of residue, okay? Okay, now at the end of variance analysis, we are making a summary table of variance analysis, okay? We have three types of variation, treatment variation, residue variation, and total variation. We have again three type of degrees of freedom. We have three sum of squares. We have two mean of squares. And at the end, we have F calculated MMS divided by RMS. We put the, we write the values of all these into the summary table, variance analysis table, okay? Okay, let's make an example and understand how can we make all these operations. Let's say we have four types of batteries. We are producing a battery or four batteries in our plant battery. We are producing four types of batteries. In order to find, we want to find the differences, if there is any differences among the performances of batteries. Okay, we have four batteries type. So N equals to, or P equals to four. And we are taking six samples from each type of batteries. So the N equals to six. And we are taking the life of batteries in these samples. The question is, the life of the batteries is given in the table, okay? The question is there any differences among the performances of batteries at alpha equal to 1% or alpha equal to 0.01? Okay, you see, we have four types of batteries, A, B, C, D. These are the types of batteries. And we are taking six samples from each type of batteries. And these are the life of batteries that we have measured. We have measured the life of batteries and put into the table. We put the values into the table. Normally, this table is given, but at the end two row, you have to add the means of each column. You have to calculate by yourself. These are the means of each column. And these values is the sum of each column, okay? You can calculate or you can write these values by yourself into the table. And this value is the total sum, okay? The total of all batteries, total life of all batteries. 1,790 is the total of all batteries. Okay, these are given. Now let's come to the solution. In the first step, remember, we were writing the hypothesis. H0 says that there is no differences among the batteries, among the performances of batteries. H1 says that there is at least one difference among the performance of batteries. At least one is different, okay? At least one battery is different. Maybe two batteries or three batteries can be different. Okay, in the second step, we are trying to find the F critical, okay? We are trying to find the F critical from F table. How can we find F critical? First, we have to know the amount of alpha. Alpha is given as in 0.01. Okay, alpha is known. So the MDF and RDF, we need to find MDF. MDF is the treatment degree of freedom. RDF is the residual degree of freedom. MDF, we calculated the degree of freedoms here. TDF equals to total degree of freedom equals to n times p minus 1. N is 6, p is 4, minus 1, 23. TDF is 23. Treatment degree of freedom equals to p minus 1. P is 4, number of types of batteries is 4. 4 minus 1 is 3. RDF is TDF minus MDF, and it's 23 minus 3, and it's equal to 20. So we put the value of 3 MDF and 20 as RDF. So we have to look at the table in order to find the F critical. We have tables at the end of chapter. We have two Fischer tables. First one is the level of error is 0.01. In the second one, the level of error is 0.05. So we are working in the 0.01 level. So we have to use this table. So MDF value, treatment degree of freedom, was 3. So in the column, we have MDF values, okay? RDF values is here. So our RDF was 20, okay? 20 from here, 3 from here. The requested F value is 4.94. So we put the 4.94 here. F critical value is 4.94. Okay, let's come to the calculated F value. In order to find the calculated F value, we are starting from the calculation of TSS. Then we will calculate MSS, then RMS, RSS. RSS. We already calculated the degree of freedom, and we have to calculate MMS, treatment mean square, residual mean square. At the end, we divide the MMS into RMS and we get F calculated. Okay, how can we calculate TSS? We can calculate the TSS as double sum xij square. Double sum xij square means the sum of squares of all values in I direction or and J direction. We are taking the square of 64 plus square of 72 and go on till square of 68, okay? We are taking the square of all values and we are taking the sum minus x double dot square. X double dot means the total of all data set. This one is x double dot. We take the square of x double dot, as you see, the square of 1790 divided by n times p. N is 4, n is 6, p is 4, so this is 24. So we get the TSS value as 4207.8, okay? This is the TSS value. Let's come to the MSS value. MSS value equals to sum of xi dot square. Xi dot square means xi dot, these are the xi dot. The sum of each column is called as xi dot, okay? We are taking the square of these four value, okay? And we take the sum of the squares of the each column, divided by n is 6, minus the second term of the equation is the same with the second term of the first equation. So we take the double dot square, 1790 square, divided by n times p, which is equal to 24. And we found the MSS value as 2136.5. Finally, RSS value is equals to TSS minus MSS. So we know the amount of TSS and amount of MSS. And we found the RSS value as 2071.3. We have already calculated the degree of freedoms. And finally, we need MMS and RMS. MMS is the MSS divided by MDF. MSS is known, MSS from here, MDF from here. We found the MMS as 712.2. RMS is RSS divided by RDF. RSS is known from here. This is RSS and this is RDF. So we found the value of RMS as 103.6. Now we are ready to calculate the F calculated. MSS divided by RSS. So it's found as 6.87. Okay, it's finished. Finally, it's finished. Now we will compare the F calculated value with F critical value. F calculated value is this one. F critical value is 4.94. We have found. We have already found from the table. So we see that F calculated is greater than F critical. So what happens? We will accept the H1. Okay. H1 is accepted. It means that there is or are difference or differences among the performance of batteries. Okay, if H1 means at least one means are different. One means are different. And we can write the summary calculations, so values, summary values into the VAT table, variance analysis table. Treatment, degree of freedom, treat, residual degree of freedom, total degree of freedom, treatment sum of squares, residual sum of squares, treatment mean of squares, and etc. And finally, we found the F calculated. Okay. Okay, the variance, this is the end of variance analysis. But variance analysis tells that there is a different one or ones. Okay. But variance analysis doesn't say that which one is different or which ones are different. In order to find the different one or different ones, we have to use multiple comparison tests. Okay, we have to use another multiple comparison test. We have many multiple comparison tests, such as LC-LSD test, Duncan test, SNK test, Bonferroni, Tkacheffe, Dunnett. We have a lot of multiple comparison tests, but in this book, we will use the LSD test, least square differences. En küçük kareler farkı testini. We will use LSD test. It's very simple test. We are looking for which one is different. First of all, we have to calculate an LSD value. LSD value is the square root of F alpha in parentheses 1 RDF. We will put a new alpha value here from the table. Then 2 RMS, 2 treatment mean square divided by N. N is the number of repeat, number of samples. Okay, let's first try to find the RMS value is known, N value is known. The only unknown thing is F value. 1 RDF, we will look at the table and look for the 1 RDF. MDF is 1. MDF is 1. So we know that RDF is 20. Okay, so 120 value is 8.10. Okay, 8.10. We put the 8.10 here. Okay, 8.10 here. And 2 times RMS. RMS is already calculated as 103.6. And it's divided by N. N is 6. So we get the RMS or LSD value as 16.7. Okay, 16.7. Now, we will compare LSD value with the compared means. Okay, with the compared means. We will compare the each set 2 by 2. Okay, we have 4 set of data. We will compare the each set 2 by 2. Okay, and we will take the absolute value of the difference. Then we will take, we will make the, we will compare the LSD value. We will compare the differences with LSD value. If LSD value is great, or if LSD value is great, there is no problem. There is no important differences. But if LSD value is less than absolute differences, it means that there is an important differences between two sets. Okay. Okay, let's come to the comparison. A minus one, I mean the mean of A minus mean of B in absolute value, 72 minus 88.3. You know, you see the means are given here. Okay. The result is 16.3. We compare the 16.3 by 16.7. So LSD value is greater than absolute differences. So there is no problem. The importance is not, or difference is not important, okay? There is no important differences between A and B. The A and C differences is 4. Again, less than 16, less than LSD, no, not important. A minus D is 10. Again, less than LSD. B minus C is 12.3, again, which is less than 16.7, not important difference. B minus D equals to 26.3. So this value is greater than LSD value. It means that there is an important difference between B and D dataset. Okay, there is an important, statistically important difference between B and D. C minus D, again, it's less than LSD value. There is no important differences. So we can say that, okay, there is only one important differences between set B and set D, okay? Or between battery B and battery C, battery D. C miydi, D miydi? B ile D arasında önemli bir fark vardır diyoruz. Evet arkadaşlar, bu iki küme birbirinden önemli derecede farklıymış. Diğerlerinin arasındaki fark o kadar da önemli değilmiş. Hangi düzeyde? Alfa 0.01 hata düzeyinde. Evet, that's it. We finished the variance analysis. We found the different one or the different ones.